Hello everybody, today is June 2nd, 2012. I found this article called Zombies, Rabies, and Synetic Genomes. What it proves here is that the government knew that the hybrid rabies virus that is airborne was out as far back as 2007. And this is basically a cover story to force the direction of where this new virus came from. And what they're suggesting here is someone in their basement or possibly a bathroom created this virus. Many years ago, there was a book that came out called Missing Time by Bud Hopkins. And there was talk that this book was put out not to inform people, but to draw people out. The government wanted to find out how many people had been abducted by the aliens. And I think that's what's going on now with these new news releases. They're releasing that there is pockets of this rabies virus. And they're not asking, you know, law enforcement to notify them of bizarre behavior or bizarre attacks to be reported to the CDC. But they're monitoring the internet to see how many people actually are responding and reporting their own experiences. Now, this article was written in 2009, but it mentions the cover-up as far back as 2007, and I'm sure it goes back even farther. I had posted two articles that were posted in 2008 and 2009 by National Geographic Society, stating how the rabies virus has mutated and is now airborne, just like a flu virus. And you guys really need to see that, to watch that if you haven't. This reads, in the late 2008 horror movie, Quarantine, a sort of doomsday cult created a hybrid rabies virus in the basement of a Los Angeles apartment building. But before the virus was ready to be unleashed, it apparently bolted out the door and began infecting the immediate human population. Not surprisingly, the virus was designed to cause infected humans to quickly turn mad and would gnaw on every other uninfected humans they encountered, spreading the virus exponentially to other humans, who then went mad and bit other humans, and you get the picture. Charles Faddis, a 20-year-old veteran of the CIA who headed up the agency's WMD counterterrorism branch, noted that Aum Suriko, the Japanese doomsday cult, had worked on developing pathogens the group hoped would infect and kill every human on the planet. Perhaps it was only coincidence, but in March 2007, Homeland Security Today cover report Viral Visions, a hybrid genetically engineered rabies virus, was hypothesized that could cause those infected to become mad enough to want to bite, in the process transmitting the virus. Now, I want you to know that this new virus that has mutated, and it didn't mutate on its own, doesn't take a year, but only weeks, possibly even days, to infect the host. Viral Vision focused on disturbing new developments in geomatics and biological research that increasingly are providing the potential for new and lethal designer pathogens. Earlier this month, the Wall Street Journal tackled this issue in the story, In Attics and Closets, Biohackers Discover Their Inner Frankenstein. Under the subhead, Using Mail-Order DNA and Iguana Heaters, Hobbyists Brew New Life Forms, the report highlighted that do-it-yourself tinker with the building blocks of life in the comfort of their own homes. The report asked whether these biohackers pose a threat to national security. According to the Wall Street Journal report, a senior official in the FBI's Weapons of Mass Destruction Directorate says the Bureau is working with academic and industry to raise awareness about the biosecurity, particularly in light of the expansion of affordable molecule biology equipment and genetic databases. A variant of federal officials who expressed these same concerns to Homeland Security Today more than 2 years ago reiterated their worries this week, pointing to the very sort of home basement virology labs that were described in the Wall Street Journal report. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, this is all bull hockey. You need a level 4 lab to create such viruses because they would contaminate themselves and be dead before they were able to accomplish what they wanted to do. So to try and say that someone's creating deadly pathogens to kill the entire planet in some basement somewhere is just... So whoever came up with this scenario, all I can say is they were playing too many video games. It goes on. The ability to create nasty pathogens like your hybrid rabies virus in your bathroom is becoming easier and easier, one of the authorities told HS Today US. In the opinion of many in my field, this is much easier than trying to get enough fissile material to make a nuclear bomb and then being able to construct an effective bomb. In the world of these hybrid pathogen virus-inspired zombies, think the movie 28 Days Later, are possible. A virologist who helps the intelligent community, IC, kept track of the work being done in field of genetic engineering as it specifically relates to virology research and development, told Homeland Security Today. Viral threats carefully are being monitored by American intelligence authorities and bioweapons experts. And apparently there's a reason for them to be even more concerned than they were 2 years ago. Now that would make it 2007. The Viral Visions report noted that the ability of individuals to create frightening new viruses in their basements was rapidly growing. Like I said, this is just, it's all baloney. It's baloney to cover up the fact that they got this hybrid rabies virus that got out either intentionally or unintentionally and is out of their control. And right now they're just searching the internet for stories of pocket of outbreaks, or maybe they're deliberately doing these outbreaks in different areas and studying the results. And this is all just basically a cover story, a big lie. The Central Intelligence Agency, CIA, began worrying in earnest about designer pathogens soon after October 2001 anthrax attack provided evidence indicating the anthrax had been weaponized. An expert panel was convened to study the problem and to make an assessment of the seriousness of a synthetic viral threat. It was later disclosed that this anthrax came from a government lab from a man who worked there at a level four facility. So saying that someone created it in their bathroom is just bull. Now I want you to take note of the synthetic viral threat. I have another article that I want to read to you, and it's about BP and their research in developing synthetic virals and synthetic bacteria. This article about this synthetic bacteria that BP was working on is dated 2010. And this article is dated 2009. So here we are, 2012, and it just shows you how much technology in just 1 year had leaped forward. So you can imagine how much has leaped forward in another 4 years. Here it says, while the synthesis of small segments of DNA has been possible for 2 decades, the use of these early techniques to produce a genome, the complete blueprint in the form of DNA for the construction of an organism, would have required years of work and been prohibitively expensive. Well, we know now that's not true. DNA production and assembly techniques have advanced to the point that a medium-sized virus can now be constructed in weeks. In addition, these improvements have led to rapid increase in the number of companies that offer whole gene synthesis. Say that 10 times real fast. The resulting competition has lowered prices to within the budget of most researchers. So anyways, the point being, as far back as 2007, they started to create cover stories about the genetically engineered rabies virus. And then did some more cover stories in 2009. And I believe now they're only releasing bits of information, trying to find out what people know, where it's at, is it spreading, etc. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.